This episode is sponsored by Goodyear. Goodyear is here to help last-mile fleets achieve total mobility from the first mile to the last. That means the trusted products to help your fleet get longer wear and better fuel economy, a nationwide premier service network to support your fleet at every turn, and complete tire management to help detect and prevent issues before they happen. To discover how your last-mile fleet can achieve total mobility, schedule a consultation today.
Welcome to Truck Chat Fleet 101, an educational series from Work Truck. I'm Lauren Fletcher, Executive Editor of Work Truck, and today's episode discusses one of the most commonly misunderstood topics we hear about at Work Truck. What is torque? When you're in the middle of doing vehicle research for your vocational fleet, there's no doubt you've come across the term torque a vast majority of the time. Have you developed a deep understanding of its meaning? This video will have you speaking about the concept like a pro in no time. So, what is torque? First off, we need to set the record straight. Although related to one another, horsepower and torque are two different things. While both are an indicator of power, torque will likely be of more interest to those in the world of vocational fleet. Simply put, torque is an indicator of towing power, while horsepower is the maximum power available to a vehicle and has more to do with the speed and the rate at which an engine accomplishes work. For a basic comparison, you'll likely see many sports cars with higher levels of horsepower than a truck meant for heavy lifting and vice versa. Okay, so how is torque measured? You've likely gotten pound foot and foot pound mixed up and weren't even aware there was a difference. According to Engine Labs, a pound foot, also referred to as a Newton meter in the metric system, is a unit of torque and a vector measurement created by 1 pound of force acting on a 1 foot lever. On the other hand, a foot pound is a measurement of work. Work is the measurement of force over a given distance. It measures the energy required to move a 1 pound object 1 foot of linear distance. In simpler terms, pound feet is the official measurement of torque, the force that helps the truck start moving from a stop and pulls it up steep hills. BMW states the formula for torque as follows: torque equals force times a lever arm. Newton, or pound, stands for the acting force, while meters, or feet, stand for the length of the lever arm being used to enact the twisting force. So, now, where does the torque come from? Essentially, torque is the rotational force of an engine that measures how much of that force is available when an engine exerts itself, according to Toyota. As the pistons in an engine move up and down on an engine's crankshaft, torque is the force that keeps it constantly rotating at a certain speed. From there, torque is shifted to the vehicle's wheels through the transmission and drivetrain. For an even simpler visual, think about twisting a jar open with your hand, turning a wrench to tighten a bolt, or even opening a door by rotating a doorknob. In a piece for Work Truck sister publication Heavy Duty Trucking, writer Rolf Lockwood stated, "In an engine, torque is generated by the pressure load of the expanding gases on the top of the piston times the stroke, meaning how far the piston moves. Two basic principles apply. Torque is stronger at the lower end of an engine's operating range, while horsepower is higher at the upper end, and a bigger displacement engine will produce more power than a smaller one, simply because there's more area for combustion to force down those pistons." What causes differences in torque? All trucks are not created equal when it comes to torque, and that's because the level of torque produced is impacted by the amount of air flowing through the engine. Larger engines produce more torque because they pump more air. Piston length will also cause differences in torque. Diesel engines, for example, will create greater torque because the piston moves relatively farther, resulting in longer strokes. At this point, you may be thinking, well, this is well and great, but why does it matter? With all the technical information out of the way, now it's time to discuss the benefits of torque for vocational fleet drivers. The low-end revolutions per minute generated by higher levels of torque is what allows the engine of a truck to easily carry heavy loads and move quickly after coming to a stop. For example, trucks will move slowly when moving up a hill with a trailer or heavy load. Therefore, the engine RPM will be low, enabling the vehicle to operate smoothly for the task at hand. According to a subject matter expert at General Motors, in simple terms, torque is the twisting power of the engine to get and keep your vehicle moving. A fleet might benefit from a truck with more torque if they have heavy payload or towing needs, as higher torque combined with low engine RPMs often leads to better performance when starting from a stop. GM noted that diesel engines naturally have high torque at low RPMs, which is one reason they're often preferred for heavy-duty applications. And an expert from Ram Commercial told us that businesses expect their vehicles to do it all, so power and torque are important. Delivery services require ample power and torque, whether they're an expediter or a final mile service, to cover miles of interstate, city streets, and all the rolling topography in between. Whether it's a landscaping company towing a trailer, a plumber hauling heavy pipes, or a contractor carrying marble countertops, power and torque are necessary to get in and out of the job site. Something important to note is that torque isn't the only factor that affects a vehicle towing capacity. Components such as wheels, tires, suspension, and the transmission also play a critical part in the overall equation. For more information on torque, or if you're looking for more Fleet 101 and Truck Chat videos, check out the links below. And thanks for tuning in, and watch out for more episodes of Truck Chat coming soon, where I'll continue to focus on the people, the issues, and the vehicles that matter most to work truck fleets.